What is Polytechnic GPA? The GPA, grade point average, is a system which provides an overview of a student's academic performance. Basically, it determines whether you can obtain a scholarship, the universities that you can enter or cannot enter, and tells you how well you're doing in the academic race. Here's an example of the grading system in Ngee Ann Poly. How the GPA is calculated is pretty much the same across all polytechnics. The only difference is that different polytechnics might have different namings for their grades. For example, NP would say that B is a very good grade, while SP thinks that it's just good. So it doesn't make much of a difference because the GPA awarded is still the same, it's still 3.0. So I guess schools just likes to make things unique and unnecessarily complicated. Now, how is the semester GPA calculated? The formula for semester GPA is the sum of grade points times credit units, divided by the sum of credit units for the modules examined in the semester. So let's use Ngee Ann Polytechnic as an example. To calculate the GPA for a semester, you need to first check the credit unit for the modules in the semester. So for NP, you can search the course up and look at the bracketed credit unit at the side. And the credit units for each module will be multiplied with the respective grade points you acquired. In this case, Module 1, Programming 1, has a credit unit of 5. So we got an AD for this module, which would equate to a grade point of 4. The credit unit of 5 will then be multiplied with the grade point of 4 to result in 20 for that module. The credit unit times grade point for each module would be added up together, and the system will divide them with the total number of credit units taken in the semester. In this case, the final GPA would be 3.176. The PLP minor is an example of a pass-fail module. They would not be taken into your final grade. So calculating GPA manually is really a hassle, and there's a lot of tools you can use instead. One of the tools that's super handy is the website Please Grade Me. So you just need to know and key in the grade point and the credit unit per module, and they will calculate the total GPA for you. While we are at this topic, I want to talk about how a module with high credit units can affect the total grade. So let's just say we switch the grade of Programming 1, which is A, and the grade of Designing Principles, which is F. As you can see, the difference would be around 0.7, which is a super large gap. So the effect of a high credit unit module would be pretty prominent in the total grade. Now, how is cumulative GPA calculated? Cumulative GPA is the total GPA across all semesters taken so far. So let's just take the last GPA we used, 2.7, and put it into the formula. Let's say we obtain a 3.83 in the next semester. So how the cumulative GPA calculated is similar to the semester GPA. The sum of grade point times credit units divided by the sum of credit units for all modules examined, including failed modules up to and including the current semester. If we reflect this on our grades, we will be totaling up the credits from semester 1 and 2, which will get us 38. And now totaling up the credit unit times grade points from semester 1 and 2 will result in 122.5. And divide them together to get 3.22 as the cumulative GPA. So this actually brings up a question from the Q&A. If you scored badly for a semester, are your grades going to be recoverable? So for this example, we started with a 2.4 and we are able to pull it up within one semester to 3.22. So if we continue the calculation and assume that we are able to get above 3.6 for the next 4 semesters, we'll be getting around 3.5291, which is good enough to get you into university. So for this question, I would say yes, GPA is sort of recoverable, but the difficulty in maintaining a high GPA for the rest of your semester might be quite a challenge. Finally, we are here at the questions and answer stage. The first question is, does the first semester GPA have a big effect on the final GPA? I often hear online or from friends that the first semester GPA will influence your final grade a lot. But this isn't really the case as we saw in the previous example. And I would say that the first semester GPA is more of a gauge on whether you are coping well in your course or not. Generally, lessons tend to be more difficult as you progress through it, so the first semester gives you an idea on whether you are prepared for the workload, teaching style, and difficulty of your course or not. Second question, what is the GPA required for the local unis? The IGP, Indicative Grade Profile, is released every year. You can check the IGP to find out what's the cutoff point for the admitted students last year. For NUS, NTU, SMU, SUTD, a good GPA to aim for would be 3.6 and above, seeing that the majority of the cutoff point in 2023 is around that area. So for SIT and SUSS, I would say aim for at least a 3.2. This is around the medium GPA which students admitted to SIT get. Of course, for popular courses such as computer science and law, 3.9 to 4.0 might be required. Same applies for scholarships in universities. The final question is, when can you apply for universities? Once the fifth semester ends, if your GPA is above a certain amount, universities might reach out to you to invite you for early admission. So you would be able to apply to the schools earlier than your peers, and if you did not get an invite, you can apply to universities during the application period with your 5 semester results. This application period would normally be from February to March, and it varies a little depending on the school you're applying to. Alright, we are at the end of the video, and do leave a comment down below if you have any questions. And that's it for the video. Bye bye!